Hi, everybody. Now, at the end of July, this recently viral video was published that demonstrates a levitating material, claiming that it may possess superconductive properties, and became one of the most discussed videos among the scientific and social media community. Now, in the video, scientist Dr. Kim claims that they've discovered a superconductor that can operate at both room temperature and ambient pressure. Using simple and understandable language, let me explain to you what LK99 is, what superconductivity is, and how this potential discovery can affect you. So what is LK99? Well, LK99 is a potential room temperature superconductor that was first reported by a scientist team from Korean University in 1999. The material is made from a combination of lead, phosphorus, and copper, and it has a hexagonal structure that is slightly modified from lead apatite. LK99 is said to have superconducting properties at temperatures below 400 Kelvin, 127 Celsius, or 260 degrees Fahrenheit, and it operates at ambient pressure. This would be a significant breakthrough, as it would mean that LK99 can be used in a wide range of applications that are currently limited by the need to cool superconductors to cryogenic temperatures today. Now, superconductivity, in simple language, is a special state that allows electricity to flow through materials with zero resistance. Now, first things first, let's actually tackle that concept of superconductivity. So imagine that you're trying to get from your home to your favorite ice cream shop or coffee bar. Now, there's a bunch of different ways that you can get there, right? You could walk, you could ride a bike, you could drive a car, each with their own speed and obstacles. Walking might take longer and you might get tired. Riding a bike might be faster, but you'd have to avoid cars and pedestrians. Driving is fastest, but then you have to deal with traffic. But what if there was a magic path that gets you there instantly with no traffic, no obstacles, and absolutely no energy wasted? That's kind of what superconductivity is all about. It's a special state that certain materials can get into, where electricity can sort of flow through them with zero resistance. Yeah, you heard me right, zero resistance. It's like the electrical current that has been given a VIP all-access pass, and it just zooms through with no problems at all. Cool, right? Now, you might be wondering why superconductivity is actually so important. Like, what is the value of having a superconducting material anyway? First, we need to understand what happens when electricity passes through a regular conductor like copper or silver. Now, there's a thing called resistance, which is sort of like the material's way of saying, hold up, not so fast. There are electrons that are trying to move through me. Because of this resistance, some of that electrical energy is lost in the form of heat. That's why your laptop charger can actually get warm when you're using it. It's literally burning up some of the electricity as heat. Now, here's where superconductors come into play. Imagine if you could tell those electrons, hey, no need to fight, just cruise on through. That's exactly what a superconductor does. It lets the electrons move freely without any resistance at all. This means that none of the electricity is lost as heat, and it's all used exactly where we want it. It's like having a super highway for electrons, where there are no speed limits, no traffic jams, and just smooth cruising all the way. Sounds pretty cool, right? But wait, it gets even better. Superconductors aren't just efficient, they're also super persistent. If you start a current flowing in a loop of superconducting wire, it can literally keep going for years, even decades, without any power source. It's like the Energizer Bunny on steroids. So why aren't we using some superconductors everywhere? Well, there's a catch. Most superconductors only work at extremely cold temperatures, like those found at near absolute zero. Scientists are working hard to find materials that can be superconductors at room temperature, and if they succeed, it can revolutionize everything from power grids to electronics. So, if you want to learn more about superconductivity, I recommend this video. Labs across the world, from the Chinese Academy of Sciences to TU Wien, King's College in London, IIT Madras, the Institute of Mathematical Sciences in Chennai, the University of Toronto, and even Universidad de Chile, have all conducted theoretical examinations of first principles or density functional theory analyses on LK99 materials. Now, in terms of creating the material, labs across China, India, and South Korea have also been actively replicating and experimenting to produce and test the LK99 material. Likewise, another civilian and engineer who works with Varta Space Industries, Andrew McAuliffe, has been actively experimenting with LK99 replication, making new samples. While we should avoid jumping to any conclusions just yet, he has identified some odd magnetic behavior that would merit further investigation. Now, this spirit of actively experimenting and hacking with available materials and openly published science, let's just take a step back and appreciate that we live in a time where results on one side of the world can be read and then tested halfway across the other world. So what does it mean for this discovery to humanity and to you specifically? Well, if superconductivity of LK99 will be proved by labs, it will still take years and maybe even decades before the material becomes widely used due to the cost and ability to manufacture it in the specific shapes and patterns that make this usable. Now, when the material becomes cheaper to reproduce, then LK99 can actually be used for many things. Power transmission. LK99 can be used to make it more cost-efficient and effective for power transmission lines. Magnetic levitation. LK99 can be used to create magnetic levitation transportation systems, such as maglev trains, but everywhere. LK99 can be used to create quantum computers, which are more powerful than traditional computers. Specifically, this could allow the form factor for such quantum computers to be more portable, especially if the material no longer has to be super cooled or super heated. LK99 could also be used to create new medical imaging techniques that are more sensitive and precise. Overall, while it is possible that LK99 could have superconductivity properties, more research is still needed. At the moment of recording this video, the effects are still not completely proven out. So, before you jump to any conclusions and start tweeting about the floating rocks, it is necessary to keep your scientific mind clear of any biases and balance your excitement for innovation with some healthy skepticism to combat that hype. Thank you so much for watching this video. Now, did you think that LK99 will be proven as a valid superconductor, or is it just another wave of hopium in social media? Let me know. I'll try to personally answer the comments under this video. See you next time.